What are your aspirations? Typically, if you're going for a PhD, it's because you want to be a college professor, educator, or get into a very specialized R&D position. It's typically what I've seen with PhDs. So it's a lot of extra work and a lot of extra money for two primary areas. If you just want to work in a plant, work your way up through chemical manufacturing facilities, not only in engineering, but maybe in sales, or marketing, or management, or what have you, a Bachelor of Science is all you need. Possibly, yes, if you're going into sales or something, you might also need an MBA. Which a lot of, I know a lot of engineers that have gotten out of engineering and gotten into sales, or marketing, or plant management, or this or that, and they've all gone for the MBA. And typically, they do that in conjunction with going to work. So it's not not too challenging to get. You don't have to take a hiatus from employment or anything like that. So if that answers your question, that's what you're kind of looking for. If you want to get into specialized R&D or education, college professor, PhD is a way to go. But if you're looking at something else, Bachelor of Science is really all you need. And there's not much advantage to going for a master's unless you're going to go all the way to a PhD. From my experience, that's what I've observed.
Mm-hmm.
But that's what I know, what I've seen. It's different.
If you didn't learn everything you were supposed to learn as a bachelor, then it really helps to get your master's so you can pick up the second time around. I agree with most of what Brad said, except for that last one. I think if you're going to stay with a corporation, you want to get into the business side, it really does help to pick up an MBA. I didn't do that. I would have found that helpful for many of the jobs I eventually had. If you want to stay in the research area and you know, progress to the point of managing PhDs, you really need a PhD yourself. So, and then there were times when I was in jobs that related to interacting with the government, a lot of regulatory reform, legislative work on the Hill, where I felt I could have used a law degree. So it all depends on what it is you're doing. You can pick up most of this stuff on the job. And you know, companies have often good ways of educating you. Or you can actually focus on an advanced degree. The former CEO of my company, Rex Tillerson, was a Bachelor of Civil Engineering. And he became CEO of ExxonMobil, and now he's the Secretary of State. So he didn't need any additional formal education that I'm aware of other than his presidential engineering degree. He picked the rest of it up on the job.
You mentioned that you were kind of thinking about the PhD as kind of an engineering track. And you had mentioned that MBAs you can start on and do it at night. I just want to kind of give a slightly different perspective to those of you who may be considering an MBA at some point in your career. There are some companies who would value an MBA after someone has had some kind of career experience, maybe about 5 years, so that you have some career experience, whatever that is, and then you get your MBA. You are in a much better position that career experience to get into the kinds of management roles that those kinds of companies would want someone to walk into. So you do it both ways. It depends on where you see yourself going. The
good part is most companies will pay for additional education too.
That's very true. And then there's an expectation.
Oh yes,
there's always an expectation.
Yes. There's always a catch.
To build off what they said, it really depends on what you want to do or what you see yourself doing. If you see yourself becoming a professor or going into a very specialized engineering role, then yes, a PhD would be initially the best option for you. But what you also need to remember is that most companies, as we've mentioned, they'll pay for further education. So that's something that you can ask recruiters. You know, this is what I'm interested in, eventually getting a PhD in some sort of specialized field of engineering, whether it's chemical or bio or something along those lines. And you can ask them, be like, hey, what are your opportunities for employees for further education? Do you guys offer stipends? You know, what are your requirements once you've completed it? And in most cases, if you do an R&D role and you want to pursue a PhD, they will help you and you can actually apply some of your work experience towards that PhD. Or you can do, you know, a thesis or do a project with a university while working for that company. So you don't have to go Penn State chemical engineering degree for the BS, then immediately go to your master's and PhD, or your PhD, whichever way you want to go. You can actually work through it with a company. And you know, it's a matter of what you see. If you really see yourself becoming a professor, I would go straight for the PhD. You know, but then you have to consider all the additional expenses that come with going directly for that degree. So it really depends on what you're looking for. And I would recommend speaking to recruiters, especially in fields that you're interested in, and asking them, hey, what are the opportunities? This is what I want to do. And if you express that, they'll be more interested in hearing what you have to say, because it shows that you're already kind of guiding yourself or targeting something further than that initial job.